What we have done over the past few years is that because we work a lot with Department of Defense and other aspects of the US government, we went through a process of really evaluating our supply chain, and we worked on setting up what more regional focused supply chains.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now is Philipp Stratmann. He is the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies. And Philipp, good to see you again. How are you?
Doing well, Steve. Good to see you.
Yeah, so the company out with a number of deals that you've signed, working with a number of different partners in US and Colombia and all over the world. In fact, another one this morning. It just seems like this reseller part is really starting to do very well for the company.
Yeah, and I think we've said this before. What is important is for us to do responsible geographic expansions. We can't be everywhere all at once. And especially as we continue to scale, we keep on finding, looking for, and finding responsible resellers and service partners that can help us deliver the capability to the customer where the customer is located and when maintenance and services are required. They can do the first instance, and then when larger efforts are required, we'll go out there with them and we'll help them together. It is super exciting that this is something, obviously, as you said, our continued expansion in Latin America, the additional international government interest that we're getting from, allied partners of ours, but then also the expansion that we're seeing in the domestic North American market. There are tons of specialists out here in North America that service certain aspects of the commercial energy industry. And being able to partner with the right partners, be that on the West Coast or the Gulf Coast or on the East Coast, is really helping us scale the offering that we take into the market.
Let's talk a little bit about getting them out to customers now. There's obviously a number of different steps. The first one I want to talk about is the supply chain. We're obviously seeing some disruptions around the world. It's been a challenge. How has your company been able to meet those challenges?
Well, there's definitely been a lot of talk about tariffs, supply chain volatility, and everything else. What we have done over the past few years is that because we work a lot with Department of Defense and other aspects of the US government, we went through a process of really evaluating our supply chain, and we worked on setting up what more regional focused supply chains that are based near our two main facilities. So that puts us into California and into the tri-state area, Pennsylvania, New York, New Jersey. So, we source most of our steel directly from fabricators that are based in Pennsylvania. We get most of our aluminum parts from domestic supply. So what we were able to do over the past couple of weeks is look through our efforts and, reassure our customers that there is not going to be any major impacts that anybody should see from impacts on the supply chain in general. But also, more importantly, we're not going to start seeing constraints in supply. We've set up a robust, regionally focused domestic supply chain that enables us to continue building at pace and deliver to the customer base.
Yeah, let's talk about the delivery to customers. And I know you're growing your backlog as well. There's lots of things happening, but you want to grow that, I would guess, in all parts of the business, right? To make sure that everything's moving together.
Yes. So, obviously you see some of the reseller parts and some of the other work we've got going on the vehicle side, but we're equally continuing to go and pull down opportunities that sit on the buoy side. And that ongoing conversion, you identify an opportunity, take that opportunity down into a booking, and then enable that booking to be converted to revenues through our, efforts that we've got set up that we just talked about on the supply chain side, that is what enables us to scale. And if you look at the scaling the company has gone through, we're really excited to continue building on the backlog so that we can start going through that next inflection point in terms of growth. And I don't think there's ever been a better time for people to truly go and understand and want to move further into that autonomous ocean operations market. We're seeing it on the commercial side. We had a team out in Southampton in the UK last week at Ocean Business. We're seeing it on the defense and homeland security side. We were at CS Base in Washington, DC last week. It is everywhere, and we're very excited to participate in that.
Very interesting times ahead for sure, Phil. Thank you so much. Great to catch up with you and where everything's at. And we look forward to our next conversation, okay?
Great. Thanks for being on again, Steve.
Yeah, good stuff. Philipp Stratmann, the CEO of Ocean Power Technologies.